Why is not sale? It's like a night. He squeezed child into the skull of sheep. And like a clap to him, a koala, and a twig a quintk. He squeezed the gas alkland child him. The ear letters fellowship. For those that may not know, my name is Richard Armstrong. I'm from Penticton, from the Shingle Creek area. My mom is deceased, and my dad is deceased, Willie Armstrong and Lily Armstrong. My mom is from Inchilim, Washington, and my dad is from Penticton, from the Shingle Creek area. A long time ago, my mom and my dad told me a story about your area here. There's a little creek over here, not too far, just as right out of town there. And you can barely see that creek now. I came by through there when I came through there. And this one lone mountain back here by itself, they told me a story about Shortly and this area here. Shortly, long time ago, you know where they tore that road up on the word Penticton there, well, just above there, there was always Shortly there, the mountain goat. Always lots of mountain goats there, way back, even before there was people. It looked it like Skailu. Kasapi, the lihu iti le Shortly. Otli Shortly Kasapi. The hundreds and thousands of years ago, there was no people. There was just animals. One of the animal kingdoms is the four-leggeds. And one of those four-legged groups is the mountain goat. The mountain goat lived on the side of the mountain there in great big tribes. They had big leaders like our chiefs. They spoke a language. Tlaqsepi, yati tmixw, tlnqulqiltn lxtqaqalq, putxiltam nimtet, din xaltsn tlaqulqilt. Yati tmixw xnqulqiltn. Kema pnani huay, puti kun kwina achme stim, tlnqulqiltn si tmixw. Back then, the different tribes of the four-leggeds, like the mountain goat, their language, they spoke a language like us. They had great leaders and great chiefs and big tribes. And as you know, over time, there's always a change in leadership. And the tribes of the Shortly back then was not much different back then. The Shortly had a very powerful leader. Nobody could depose him. He was already getting old, but none of the young Shortlys could take his place. He was that powerful, and he had rule over all the rest is clear. Kurt Iknaks Soyalcha Ntil Swai Waiks It's question. It's kun queen place a house plan. Then I can clean me home. So one of the young mountain goats decided to challenge the old man for his reign over the rest of the mountain goats. So when he thought about it and he watched the old man, and the old man was so powerful that nobody could beat him. So he thought, well, maybe if I challenge him, I'll just get beat up and get stomped into the ground and I'll make a fool of myself. So the young wild goat decided, I have to come up with a different plan. If I challenge that powerful old man, he's going to beat me up so bad, and I don't want to make a fool of myself in front of all my people. I got to come up with a different plan. So he started talking to some of the other female of the old man. The old man had a lot of wives and a lot of different females. This young man started, young goat started talking to them, and he said, you know, you guys been here for so long. You know, there's nothing here for you guys. There's a mountain way over there, over in, just on the other side of a little creek. There's a mountain all by itself there. He said, why don't you young goats come with somebody like me, and we'll start our own kingdom. We'll have our own mountain. It's all by itself. Nobody can come and bother us. It'll be all ours. It'll be all up to us. We'll rule that little mountain there. Nobody can get to us because it's one little mountain. Anybody comes, we got the upper hand, we're on top. So over time, some of the younger goats, the female goats, started believing him. And they said, well, okay, tomorrow. He said, while it's still dark, said, you guys gather on this end of our range, and as soon as it's dark enough and everybody's all quiet and asleep, we'll come over the edge, come down the mountain, come along the highway. No. They'll come through there, and we'll end up, by the time noontime comes, we'll be in our own land, just in not too long, we'll get there. So they started coming. They started coming. So they came, and their leader told them, you guys don't have to worry about it. It's a really good place. Everything's provided. There's water, there's food, there's no problem. So they started hurrying. They started coming, and the daylight started coming. Start getting the daylight, and those females were getting tired and getting slow, and he was up ahead of them, telling them, you guys, come on, that old man's going to wake up and beat us all up. said, we're all going to get licked here. We guys don't hurry up. So he kept hurrying them. Pretty soon they came, and the women start saying, well, how much more, how far is this place? How much more we got to go? Ah, don't worry about it. We're going to be there pretty soon, and it'll be all ours. You'll have nothing to worry about. Everything's provided there. That kept on and on and on. The sun came up, and they were getting thirsty, and they told them, you can't go down. Don't can't go down to the lake. The old man will see you. You got to keep coming. So they came, and pretty soon them young goats were saying, this old guy, this young guy here, is going to kill us. He said, we're trying so hard, and he's still not satisfied. Keeps driving us really hard. That's that guy up there. That's totally. And when they came to this little creek at the end, not this one that runs through here, farther over, just right out of town, right from town there, there's a little puddle there. Used to be a nice little creek there. Pretty soon, those female goats were so dry when they would try and talk, all you could hear was their dry throat. When they would try and talk, and their throat was so parched, and they were just really having a hard time with it. And every time they try and say something, and all you could hear was their throat. They go yook, yook when they try to say something. So when they came down to that creek over there, they seen the creek, the goat, the ran across to the other side, and he said, "I'll keep lookout for the old man. The sun is way up, and he must be awake now." He said, "But you guys, you women, can stop and have a drink of water when you're finished, and then we'll carry on and go to that mountain we can see there." And so the women there, the women goats, they started going down to the water. And that guy asked him, he said, "When you guys finished drinking," he said, "where do you think we should go? Should we go up through there, or should we come lower, down hiding, down lower through here, where we can't be seen to get up to that mountain? What do you women think?" This woman goat was trying to tell that shortly we got to rest, we're tired. And he kept saying, "Well, where are we going to go through? Where are we going to go through?" So, usually when you give directions, you'd say, "Dan Quickwatch, come to Luis." And all the noise she could make was "Dan Yoke." That's the sound of her dry throat. "Dan Yoke." So that little creek over there, right at the light when you come this end of West Bank, that little creek that runs down towards Glatley Bay, maybe it is? That little creek there. That little creek, I've all my life known it as, the name of that creek is Danyuk. And all them young females said, "This young goat doesn't care that much about us. He's driving us into the ground. Why don't we just have a drink, and we'll sneak quietly, and we'll head on back to where we came from." So they all had a really big drink, and they went lower to the trees. Shortly came to the top, that little hill. Just on this side, there's some houses around there. when you go through there now, you can still see that goat out in that field there. There's a big rock there. And that's Hoti. He's still there. When I came through there a little while ago, through at the light, I turned down. And I didn't come through the main highway. Right at the light, I turned down and took that back road through there. If you go through there, look at on the top of that field, you'll see that rock there. That's Sotli. He's still there today, waiting for the females to come. So my mom and my dad and all of the people that I know told me that as long as this mountain over here, what was the name of that mountain? Tkasamkan. I think you guys call that Mount Bushri now. That was the name that my folks told me that Mount Bushri was called, Tkasamkan, meaning Tklam by itself. And they told me the name of that Mount Bushri is Tkasamkan. And as long as that's there, there'll never be a herd of goats that will ever live there because they didn't reach it. That leader of them young renegades is still standing out in the field because when the old man seen his wives coming back, that powerful Sotli from over there, he said, for a lesson, I'm going to teach you for running off with my wives. He said, you're going to stand there and be there forever. For the people to be, he said, Syilx Language and Culture, tmixw. And the lesson that they told me that goes with that is that there's a teaching in something like that, that any treachery that's planned never comes to fruition. Treachery of any kind will always be never fully completed, and that the way things supposed to be, that's the best way to do it. So that's the story I heard from my folks about your territory here, your backyard. I think that every time I come through there, I think of my mom, I think of my dad, and them telling me that story. To me, I think it would be another great thing if that stone that's out in the middle of that field is protected by you guys. To me, that tells you guys who you are as a people. Tlaqsepi is tchwachtit is kastararit sin kilips the tchwan tisyat tala huilxi skil it's huit in silhul. Yat it's khasiti sin kilipi kayula. All of those monuments in our territory, that's not the only monument within our territory. There's Coyote Rock, there's Pillar Lake, Coyote's Canoe, the pillar at Pillar Lake. There's all kinds of things within our territory, throughout our land, throughout our Syilx Nation, that tells us who we are as a people. Some of those monuments to me are as important and should be as important to all Syilx people as the pyramids would be to the Egyptians. We should be thinking about Sinclipe Kayulakuns in that kind of feeling from here, because that goes back to the time when tells us that we know that we belong here as Syilx. Khiwa, atchumkin marukha. That must be my enough story for me. I might be telling you guys too much BS. What do you think? We might start an uprising here, huh? That's left.
Clan Khamin. Okay. Aha. Okay, Lemon. Emlem Panticha. These gifts that we gave Joey and Richard here is the things that we gathered here at the school. And we canned some salmon here, and we went and got some schuchtlamil. And we canned some, what kind of berries are those? Oregon grape. And we did this at our school here with the students. We take them on the land. And that's the product of our work. And one for Clint. Limlim's luck. Thank you.